Hi, this is Luke from SoulCycle.com, and today we're bringing our sixth tutorial video on how to use Naver Maps like a pro. If you haven't seen one of our previous tutorial videos, please make sure to subscribe to our channel and check out our Naver Maps playlist, and you will have access to all of our previous tutorial videos. Today's video will show you how to share with your friends the routes that you have created on Naver Maps, and also some other cool functions such as 360 degree view, airplane view, and also satellite image view. So let's go ahead and let's get started. Last time we created a path around the heart-shaped course. Now, instead of redoing this, we want to share with our friends that we're gonna go ride with. So the simplest way is if we go down over here towards where all the direction information is, and we're going to scroll all the way down until we reach the bottom. And once we have reached the bottom, we can look here towards the left, and we're going to see this box with an arrow. It says Bunegi. What we're going to do is left click, a box will pop up, and here we can left click on the URL Bunsa. And this has copied what we've created. You can email it to your friends. And here, let's pretend like I've opened my email. I've copied the link. I've opened up a new window. And here I am. I'm going to paste this. And your route will actually appear in Naver Maps. So this is how you can share with your friends your routes that you've created, and also the information on how to get around with all of the directions. Now, some other cool features here is if we look on the top right here, you see this blue box, and then you see this white one with Korean words. If we left click on this, this will give us satellite view. So let's go ahead. And this has changed into a satellite view. So you can zoom in and see the rivers and see the mountains, etc. If you want to go back to normal view, you just look here towards the right and then right left click, and this has brought you back to just normal map view. Another really cool function is that we can look at 360 degree video. So if we click on this balloon here, let's left click, the map will change, and we can drop this anywhere that we want on the map. So let's drop it near Bampo Bridge. Go ahead and left click. Left click around here. And just wait a second, and that will bring it into an image view that you'll be able to see 360 degree. So here's the actual trail. If you want to, you can click and drag and see the 360 degree view. So I can go all the way around if I want to. Just click and drag. Click and drag. So this is a really cool feature. And this box here towards the right, it just shows you where you are in relation to the bike trail. If we don't want that, we can just close this by left clicking. If we want it again, we could just right click on this again. And if we want to move forward, you can click this arrow. If you want to see a totally different view, you can click your little white balloon here, left click on it, hold, and drag it to a new spot. And that will bring you to that spot where you can see a 360 degree image again. Another option is that you can actually see airplane view. If you look up in the sky here, you'll notice these little airplanes. So let's go ahead and let's left click on this. So now this shows you an airplane aerial view, which is really cool. You can see around some mountains, you can see the river. You can just scroll around, go 360 degree view. If you want to look at another airplane, you can left click on another airplane that you see. If you want to go back to the ground, you can just click on the ground again. Once this little icon pops up, you can left click again and that will bring you back towards the ground. It's as simple as that. Those are two really cool features that you can see 360 degree images from the ground and also from the air. Again, the 360 degree on the ground is this icon here, and the airplane one is this one here. And if you want to go full screen, you could just click this button here and you went full screen. If you want to go back to normal screen, just re-click on this to resize it. If you want to get rid of these views, you can just press on the X. That will bring you back to the map. Then left click on the airplane one, and then left click on the 360 degree image, and that will deselect it. And now you're back to normal view. Hopefully you've enjoyed our 6 tutorial video. Please make sure to check out our next one coming out soon. This is Luke from SoulCycle.com. Cycle safe and high five.